Greetings, Internet. Today is Christmas, the 24th of December. And before everything gets started, I want to build this machine. This is the Lan Party machine. It has the dual core AMD Athlon, 4 gigabytes of RAM, and yeah, it's pretty crappy. Now, all the stuff you see on top of it, that will be the upgrades. Now, one you already saw, let me just get that out of the way real quick. One you already saw was this Gigabyte graphics card. It's a GT730. Definitely a huge upgrade over the 210. I mean, it's no beast, but for what we want to do, it is fine. Now, because we already covered that, let's get into the more interesting stuff. We won't be needing that anymore, because we have now an S-Rock main board and a pretty up-to-date one. There you go. There is the number. Not gonna bother reading that. And what's more interesting is it's gonna get powered by this. This is an AMD FX processor. Now, yeah. There is so many arguing. This is a piece of shit. It's way too, not powerful and blah blah. But I read pretty good reviews on Amazon. And because this is a LAN party machine, I really wanted to keep down the money. So Intel was no option for me. And I thought, since it's already having an AMD, why not keeping it in the family and going with this? Now, I know a quad core would have easily done the job, but I mean, how cool is it that you can say you have a hexa-core? This is a 6-core, there you go. And it's already running as a factory clock speed of 3.5 gigahertz. That's just incredible. But there you go. 6-core. Got a notification, sorry. FX6300. There is a number. This is my first AMD CPU I've actually purchased new. So, yeah. And got along with it with 4 gigabytes of RAM, DDR3, the cheapest one I could find, and this, the Arctic Alpine 64 Plus, just to keep the noise down a little bit. Now, I'm really, I have one little worry that the power supply in this is not gonna run the whole system now with the new graphics card and this power guzzler. Not sure if that power supply is gonna hold up any long, so but we want to find out. I think it's a 300 watt, it's a Chinese one, but we'll see. So let's get that out of the way in a moment. And first of all, disassemble the old machine. I already started on doing it, but there's still a lot to be done. Here is the old, out with the old and in with the new. It's running off of the crappy Acer motherboard that I got from a free computer, and now it's finally gonna be replaced. Boy, I can't believe how happy I am to finally see this board gone. It has quite beast, 4 gigabytes of RAM, and I will build, actually, when I get a power supply somewhere, I can build a whole new system again from this hardware. So it's not lost. They even have a case for it. Actually, the case where it came out. So the only thing that will stay in there will be the optical drive and the power supply. The hard drive in a moment is out as well, but that will be put in anyway. So let me just get all out. Well, all. Disconnect wires, get the main board out, and yeah, then we'll see us again. Well, I just realized that this main board has still IDE. And IDE is old and outdated, and this optical drive, well, guess what it works with? IDE. Now, my new main board, I highly doubt that this thing will have IDE. And because I don't have any SATA optical drives, we have to be super modern and say, well, no optical drive. At least from that way it looks like right now. So, yeah, I might find an adapter somewhere, but I don't really think. But it doesn't even look that bad, actually, with this huge-ass cooler and all the RAM slots filled. Yeah. It's a weird color, but still. I mean, why does it have always to be black? Okay, now... No, not racist. Now what we will do is... I will unbox the new mainboard. Install the processor and the RAM. And, see ya. So let's see what the amazing company of ASRock has to offer us here. We have a manual and the plate thing. That will be helpful. And driver CD. Can't even use that. Not that I would. Yeah. But what I find really cool. SATA cables. I have enough of them, but still. And of course, that's how it works. Alright. The ASRock, or ASRock, or however you call it, motherboard. Here it is. Man, I haven't unboxed the new motherboard in a long time. Here it is. Yeah, that looks like way better than the old Acer motherboard. We have, I mean, it's pretty basic, of course. I mean, I didn't purchase any gaming branded shit or something like this. I just purchased the one that fits the socket, and it's really all that mattered. It has a PCIe Express, so... Oh, and I just see right here, we have IDE as well! Oh, yes! So, we still have backwards compatibility... God. ...with the optical drive. And right now, I'm a little shocked, because I see a 8-pin power connector. And I think my power supply doesn't have it. Let me just see. It has two. All right. Everything good. Everything fine. Now from this alone, you can see that this thing definitely requires some power. And I kind of compare the CPU cores with cylinders in cars. I mean, a 4-cylinder quad core, that's, you know, what everyone has right now. It's fast and stuff, and yeah, it's pretty much all you need. A 6-core AMD is, well, a little step up in the game. And an 8-core, like an 8-core Intel Core i7, is like a V8. It's something incredible fast and powerful and something you really don't really need, but it's just cool to have. And that's why I got the middle thing. I can't afford an 8-core, that's why I got a 6-core. And I don't care how much a better deal I could have gotten with a Core i3 something. This is the one I wanted, because it has 6 cores. I'm being fucking serious, guys. So yeah, let's get inside of this beast. What the hell? I mean, it clearly opens up here. Yeah, there we go. God. Also, I learned that unlocked means you can overclock this thing. I'm not gonna do that probably because it already has 3.5 gigahertz, which is quite a high frequency to begin with. But if we have this thing now, because this is the stock cooler, and this really looks like it's right off a Pentium 4. I'm being serious. There you go. It looks... ugh. And it's probably loud as well. But yeah, still good to have as a backup. And I'm actually thinking that... I mean, it would do the job just fine on the 3.5 gigahertz. But yeah. It's also from aesthetics, you know. Because this is what really matters. Huge ass cooler. Even if you don't need it, it's always good to have. And another box we can't get open. Alright, that really looks very similar to the other one. Well, it's the same company, what surprise. Yeah, I know, but still. Now let's inspect it real quick. That should work. Alright, inspection done. Let's get on with the RAM. That even rhymed. Okay, we got unboxings over unboxings, but I can do that with my fingernail. This RAM is really small. Damn, that's some slim RAM. Oh yes. I just want to show you that real quick. We all know these gigantic RAMs where they have heat sinks on them and have got a huge brand name and stuff, and here it is. Look at this. Oh, it's so cute. It's so small. I mean, it's still a RAM, and it's DDR3, so that's all I wanted. Alright, let's get to the nitty gritty. Here is the CPU, the 6-core monster. Yeah, let's put it in. There it is, it's in. And now let's close it. And that means the socket works. Now all we need to do is put on the cooler and find out the panel ports of it. And then we're ready to put this inside the case. The cool cooler is installed. So what's next? Putting it in the case. Now I have to admit, this old panel thing does look way better because it has all these colors, and here it's just shiny. A little too shiny. So the main board is in. Looks good. Looks fine. But there is this one thing. It's gonna be quite a pain to connect the headers because it's right next to the power supply. And we got also the old problem again. And I was really... what? Ah! Which just looks so looking forward to boot this thing up today, but I can't. Because we got this old... Got this old problem here again. See this? There is power. There is power cord. Doesn't reach. And now, we have one extension. And the second one... well... it really sucks, actually. So, I have to connect all the stuff and order another extender. Yay. Here it is. I wanted $7 for this thing. Probably got ripped off. Oh guys, I've waited for this moment so long, and it finally, there you go, it runs, and it's booting Windows, and we have a blue screen. Okay, now, I'm actually thinking that, I was really thinking that I cannot boot this up just like this with all this hardware change, because it's quite a change. New mainboard, new processor, And Windows doesn't like this sort of style. So I'm just trying to boot this. There we have Windows 10, a complete install, brand new, but without any drivers, just the Windows ones. So that could work, but first let me get into the BIOS. Yes! There we go. AMD FX6300, 6-core, 3.5 gigahertz. And there we have the RAM. So 8 gigabytes. That's quite an upgrade from what it was. Even the date is right. Not the time, but the date. That's quite cool. So I'm just looking through all of this. I'm gonna leave it how it is for now. I'm gonna get into here. Yeah, that's correct. And I'm thinking that this CPU does not have a internal graphic, so it needs the graphics card. So yeah, let me just hook up the SSD and see if it boots. Let's just give it power and try to boot Windows 10. If it doesn't work, I'll just reinstall it. But I'm actually really confident that it boot. There we see the ASRock logo. It looks even better than on my main PC. Because my main PC is also an ASRock and it's very simplistic. It just says ASRock. Not even with a special font or anything, just boring ASRock. But I know, it's the simplicity. That's what it is. So we see Windows 10 loading and all the devices are being... Whoa, okay, yeah, that was fast. That was really fast. I did not expect this. Okay, now let's see. Just run, what am I doing here? Go in here. Still needs to download the graphics driver, that's for sure. Okay, but that looks pretty good, guys. I just want to see this AMD. That's all I want to see for now. Yeah, AMD FX6300, 6-core processor. Look how it brags. 6-core processor. And I'm just seeing it right now. Oh god. I really have to reinstall Windows 10. Why, you ask? Well, this is a 32-bit install. and it's for the Fujitsu, as you can see. They're Fujitsu. So, because this is a new, actually quite fast PC now, we can't leave it at Fujitsu, even if it's just the model number inside Windows. And we can't waste so much RAM and run a 32-bit operating system on it. That's just ridiculous. I'm the only one who does that right now, buying a 6-core processor and then running a 32-bit Windows. So I'm just gonna do a reinstall. Should go fairly quick, and then I'll be back. So I made a few changes here. We have the SSD here, that's the boot drive, and we have, look how it's like, that's kind of cool, whatever, it fell down, and here we have the old drive, Jesus, the data drive for now. It still has Windows 7 on it. I'm actually planning on erasing it and, you know, redoing everything, because I have a data partition on it, so I can erase Windows 7 and maybe join it to one bigger partition or just keep it, I don't know. So let's see if it boots now with everything the way it is. Damn, that's dangerous. Holy crap. Oh god. These long cables, damn. So I booted off of the right disk, and now we can see if it mounted. Yeah, that looks pretty good. We got here, that is Windows 7, and here that is the data partition. Yeah, so what I'll do now is I will move the Steam folder to the data partition and then erase the drive D so that we have one big volume, because I don't care about having three volumes and then one is like two, how much is it? 29 gigs. Yeah, I already expected that. We don't have enough space. So what the hell do we do now? Copy to the SSD for now? That could be an idea. Maybe I'll even leave it there. But then the whole data drive situation is kind of useless. So let me just figure out what I'm going to do. Okay, we are with an insane copying speed here of 1. Oh god, even less megabytes per second. Now it's speeding up a bit, but damn, that's slow. Okay, it hurt me, I'm sorry. Yeah, keep going up. Oh, it's going back down. What the hell is that? Well, I'm copying, that's my plan. I'm copying the Steam folder to the SSD for now, which is about, I think the Steam folder is about 72 gigabytes, so I have enough space on the SSD. But then I'll format the data drive to a whole 250 gigabytes, and then I'll move it back over there. And that will take ages, but it's still faster than downloading all the games or copying them again, so, like from an external source. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, the PC is done, but there is one last step on completing this build. And that is a new power supply. So I ordered that. I got it for a special deal, 30% off. And I just couldn't resist. This is a 450 watt power supply. This should do the job easily. And I don't have to worry about it, well, giving up the ghost or taking the whole motherboard and processor with it. That would suck. That would suck, really. So I was a little afraid of that. Even though it runs and I even ran some games. I mean, yeah. It does run, but it's a Chinese power supply, and I don't really trust in that. So I went with the good old Corsair. I also have a Corsair power supply in my main PC. It's way stronger, though. But
can't really complain about that. So, and that was also not so expensive. Again, I got 30% off.
It would cost normally around 75 euros, I'm not sure, but I got it really cheap. So, I mean, yeah, this turn, actually, did I mention that this turned into a little money pit? Did I really mention that? Well, I did not intend to spend that much money on a system like this. I put the AMD FX sticker that came with the CPU on the case, and it doesn't even, why the understatement? It doesn't even brag about it being a 6-core. Just, you don't even know what FX. It's just AMD FX unlocked. This is too much understatement, guys. Well, haha, talking about understatement, this PC has nothing on it and it has a quad-core Xeon. So, yeah, there you go. That's proper understatement. I almost... Seriously... what I want to say is I will start going to university, and there I will move to an apartment, and there I need a PC that is not too slow, so that could do the job easily.
And so I have a little second main PC. I don't really want to take the iMac. I want a PC, so yeah, that could also be a nice option for that.
Well, if you don't give a shit about cable management,
you have the situation I have now. In fact,
most of the stuff your power supply has
is now free, but there is stuff like that.
You can see right there where the SATA cable needs to be unplugged. in order to get the whole cable out, or even both SATA cables. Well, that's insane. Let's just do that. All right, here we go. Now you can see that this is not a professional power supply and a cheap one. Why? Because it has all the cables attached, and the more pricey ones are all modular, and they allow you to of course get the minimum the blah, 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 blah. How do you say it? The minimal amount of cables in your case, and that
looks better. But with this, well, we have
the full loaded power supply, which is good. But I won't be needing a lot of those, so it's already messed up here. So Corsair already messed it up when they packaged it. Of course, Corsair's fault, not mine. Saw me unwrapping it professionally. It couldn't have happened something like this. So here is all. That's what we want. That's what we want. And that's what we want. So just install it, power it on, done. Okay, so we are done. I even did some cable management. Now any serious PC builder will now say, well, this is the best you can do, oh shame on you. Well, you're right, but this case does not offer a whole lot of abilities to cable manage. And just look at this. This is the first situation. I have to put the CPU cable. I can't put it away. I have to put it all the way through here, because here is the CPU power. And if I round it like round the back here or so, we have the good old problem of it not reaching the power socket. So I have to kind of route it around here. Same goes for the ID cable, this stupid, big, ugly ID cable. If I put it back, it will not reach. So I did my best on putting the power cables away. I could put these away as well, but I just did not feel around fiddling again with these headers. These are just too much work. And also this, there's no way I can route it somewhere. Less here, and they would be like this. I mean, you would not see this. So really, it doesn't matter. And the back looks, of course, awful. Here we go. Sorry for the low light, but I just want to know how bad it is to get this thing close now. So I'm gonna do that and boot it up. So we're now ready to boot with the Corsair power supply. Just gonna flip the switch to on. Already was, okay. And now I'm gonna press the power button. And we got a light, that's always good. Doesn't mean everything, but that's promising a lot. And yeah, that looks good. That looks fine. And you can't find any device, that's fine as well. Here we go. Windows 10 boot screen. Sorry for the flickering. I know I need to get a better camera. I need to get better everything. Okay. That's the wrong account. Here we go. So, that's the gaming account. Yeah, I mean, it's a PC. There's nothing too crazy to show. I installed the... there we go, 6 core again, showed you. I installed the Nvidia driver, so games run smoother now. And I just want to get into Steam here. Launch Rocket League. And play it a bit. Have the convenient Steam FPS counter on the top. You cannot see it, I'm sorry, it's very small. Even hardly I can see it, but we got 61 frames per second. That's with very shitty and low settings. So let's crank it up. Do everything, set everything to high.
Here you go. High settings, it runs at a constant 47 to maximum 53 frames per second, which is more than I ever wanted. So this is way more than I ever wanted. Now for, I'm gonna launch one more game because you wanna see it, I know that. Oh, I just, stupid keyboard, just set it to sleep. But what I'm gonna do to close out this video, I'm gonna run Cinebench on my main rig here and see how this 6-core steps up with it. So yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so now we're running Chivalry with a maximum settings, and now I knocked down a frames. It's running about 36 at the most, which is, you know, fine to game. It's definitely playable, and again, if I set it down, it will easily run at 60. So there we go, that's my benchmark. If you wanted some really nice benchmarks, just don't watch my videos, you know that, so that's where I subscribe. But the one way I'm really curious about is how this steps up against my main PC. It's currently running the Cinebench, and I just can't wait to compare these two systems. It's kind of fun that the computer I actually wanted to be a kind of budget PC has the most cores in my whole computer fleet. Yeah, it's really funny.
So these are the numbers to beat. It's definitely not gonna get these 120.33 frames since the graphics card is just way better. Here you have the specifications, Intel Xeon E3 quad core 3.3 gigahertz. So there you go, R9 to 80, and it's got 694 CB. I don't know what that means, cubes. But that's the one it beat, so I'm just so curious, god damn it. Okay, well, the graphics are 51.05, so my main rig still has more than double the power, but still not bad for a graphics card that I actually paid really, really slow, little for. So, here is the 6-core showing its power.
Okay, I can't really verify if this is 100% correct, because I'm just seeing now that it only detects 3 cores, but 6 threads, so it does score 334, so if that's correct, the Xeon is still double better. So you can see that this price point is good price, good performance
for the price. But it's not quite as good as Intel. So, yeah, kill me, AMD fans. I like this CPU. Yeah, yeah. For the fact that it has 6 cores and was pretty cheap, performance pretty good. And for most people, oh, what am I saying? Way too overpowered. But still,
it's not better
than a Xeon quad core. Okay, but not stopping there, since this 3-core thing I don't believe that shit. So I'm gonna run another benchmark and see how these two compare again.
So I'm testing it with Catzilla, where this PC is really kicking it with 139 FPS. You can see that.
And I know it's not the most accurate, and it's the lowest resolution because I don't have the pro version, and I don't give a shit. I just want to see two numbers where this PC is better.
So yeah, it's that is quite good. So here is really some CPU power. Oh dear, maybe I'm just a little spoiled by my main PC, but you seriously do not have a lot of frames on this system. Yeah, there you go. It's mostly the graphics card. Here is some CPU power. Yeah, it's doing a quite good job there, but Oh,
that's actually pretty bad. Oh, there you go. There's the CPU power coming from.
Okay.
So my main PC got a 3-star certification and a score of 30,000
905. And what's interesting is CPU 781, and that's what really sparks my interest. So, well, sorry AMD fans, but this thing got crushed. We got a total score of only 3,117 and 149 on CPU. I'm a little disappointed. If this would be a quad core budget, fine. It would be a dual core, fine. But it's a freaking 6-core and it cannot do more than 200. That's sad. But benchmarks aren't everything. I mean, I did not build this in order to crush anything. I just want a smooth running system which can run the games, which it can do perfectly. So you can see benchmarks are not everything. And I can also edit a video on this, I guess.
But it's really
power hungry, and
for that, I would actually not recommend the CPU, guys. We can get way better deals, but again, I bought it.
It has 6 cores, that's what I wanted. It was cheap, and it's an AMD. So yeah, here you go. That's the end of the new 6-core build. I like it. It runs everything I need to do. And yeah, it's better than my MacBook Pro, though, I guess. So I still need to verify that, but at least that. So yeah, thank you for watching. I enjoyed building this computer. It's finally something better than just a ghetto slammed together
2005-ish computer. Now it's a little up to date. And
yeah. So if you enjoyed the video, see ya. Oh yeah, if you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe, do all this stuff, and then goodbye.